Self-contained breathing apparatus, like any critical equipment, requires proper maintenance. It is annually necessary to do complete disassembly and maintenance of the SCBA, according to the manufacturer's manual. Qualified user should regularly check and maintain for the further safe and failure-free operation of the apparatus. Dezega authorized service centers will help you carry out the necessary maintenance, using original spare parts and provide a guarantee for the performed work. Place the breathing apparatus on a solid surface in front of you. Perform the visual inspection, checking the completeness of the breathing apparatus and the correspondence of the SCBA serial numbers and its assemblies, specified in the BA data sheet. During the breathing apparatus maintenance, cleaning and recharging, it is necessary to disassemble it into the main nodes. In order to disconnect the harness system, press the spring lock and disconnect the shoulder ring. Press the two spring locks in the direction of the waist belt with both your thumbs at the same time. Open and disconnect the breathing apparatus shield. Make sure that the oxygen cylinder is closed and the connections are not dirty. Manually loosen the connection between the cylinder valve and the oxygen distribution unit and unscrew the slip nut. Take the cylinder with both hands and remove it by lifting it up, starting with the bottom. Disconnect the breathing bag from the oxygen distribution unit by manually unscrewing the two nuts. Disconnect the no oxygen signal device pipe fitting from the T by pulling the clip toward the oxygen distribution unit. Disconnect the inhalation and exhalation hoses from the cooler and the absorbent cartridge, respectively. Pull out the inhalation and exhalation valves from the cooler and the absorbent cartridge. Unscrew a special screw and disconnect the plug or the face piece. Disconnect the breathing bag from the cooler and the absorbent cartridge. The absorbent cartridge is connected to the cooler via a bayonet connection. Press down on the regenerative cartridge clip and remove the entire breathing system while lifting the cartridge. Disconnect the cooler by turning it 45 degrees counterclockwise against the absorbent cartridge connection axis. Remove the cooler lid. Unscrew the locking nut and remove the relief valve. If checking or adjusting the oxygen distribution unit becomes necessary, unscrew the screw with a wasted shank using a screwdriver and disconnect the unit. The regenerative cartridge of the P30EX could be filled using a tamper or a funnel. Pour Dezega CO2 absorbent desorb through a sieve with 3mm holes. Use the remaining absorber to fill the cartridge. Weigh the empty cartridge with a plug with an accuracy of 5 grams. Press the clips together and remove the regenerative cartridge plug. Make sure no waste absorbent remains in the regenerative cartridge and the cartridge is cleaned, disinfected, and dried. Pull the hook of the tensioner through the hole of the regenerative cartridge bottom mesh. Pull back the partition using the tensioner. Spin the nut until the springs are compressed and the partition meets the base plates. Install the tamper casing on the cartridge neck. And pour Dezega desorb absorbent in 3 or 4 portions, compacting it with a slight tap of the palms on the side of the cartridge casing. After tapping no longer results in visible compaction, fill Dezega desorb absorber to about 3/4 of the tamper casing. Insert the cover with a pin into the case and compact the soda lime absorber with an energetic hit of the cartridge casing with your palm. Compact the absorber until the stock goes all the way down. Unscrew the slip nut and remove the tamper from the cartridge. Put the plug on the cartridge neck and insert both protruding clips arches under the inner end of the neck. remove the tensioner. To do this, unscrew the nut and pull the hook out of the loophole. The cartridge could also be filled using a funnel. In this case, when compacting the last portions of the absorbent, slightly press it with your fingers through the neck while simultaneously tapping the side of the cartridge casing with the palm of your other hand. The level of the absorbent should coincide with the edge of the neck. After installing the plug, remove the remains of the absorbent through the necks by shaking the cartridge. To remove the small fractions of the absorbent, blow with air through the necks for 1 minute, flow rate 200 to 400 dm cubed per minute. Weigh the cartridge with an accuracy of 5 grams and compare to its weight before filling. The weight of the absorbent should be at least 2.3 kilograms. Install the relief valve in place and secure it with a slip nut. The valve opening must face the face part of the cartridge. When shaking a filled cartridge, there must be no movement and overfilling of the entire weight of the absorbent. Before assembly, all parts and components of the breathing apparatus must be cleaned, disinfected, and dried. Make sure that the BA parts do not have any deformations, breaks, and other damages. The serial numbers of the nodes correspond to those specified in the datasheet. Ensure that all sealing elements are in place and tight, and that connections are not contaminated with oil or grease. Reassemble the breathing apparatus in reverse order. If the oxygen distribution unit is pulled out during breathing apparatus disassembly, install the unit with a signal device and a capillary tube with a pressure gauge into the protective case. Screw in the screw with a wasted shank. Connect the cooler to the regenerative cartridge. To do this, mate the bayonet connection of the cooler and the regenerative cartridge with a displacement of 45 degrees and turn the cooler clockwise against the axis of connection with the regenerative cartridge all the way in. Put the lid on the cooler. Use the lid during operation only with an ice pack. Install inhalation and exhalation valves into the cooler and the regenerative cartridge. The design of the valves prevents them from being installed incorrectly. Connect the breathing hoses to the cooler and the regenerative cartridge. Use a special screw to secure the mask on the connecting box. In case of placement for long-term storage, replace the mask with a plug. Connect the breathing bag to the necks of the cooler and the regenerative cartridge. Install the breathing system into the protective case of the breathing apparatus. To do this, push the lower part of the regenerative cartridge under the reinforcing frame and then gently turn the cartridge with the cooler forward until it locks into place. Ensure that the breathing hoses and the breathing bag would not be crushed or pressed between the protective case of the breathing apparatus and the regenerative cartridge. The breathing bag should be freely located in the compartment and it shouldn't be twisted. Connect the flange of the breathing bag to the signal device of the oxygen distribution unit and the continuous oxygen supply fitting. Connect the fitting pipe of the bag to no oxygen signal device. Inspect the rubber gasket carefully. It must not be damaged or swollen. The mating surfaces must be clean. Take the cylinder with both hands and install it in the protective case of the breathing apparatus. Connect the valve of the oxygen cylinder to the muff of oxygen distribution unit. Tighten it manually. Screw the slip nut freely onto the cylinder fitting without a wrench using. Ensure that there is no oxygen leakages at the point of connection of the cylinder and the unit using the soap bubble test. Place the breathing apparatus horizontally on a stable surface with the outside of the protective case down. Attach the lower part of the shield to the lower hinges of the protective case and close it by simultaneously pushing on the clips. Click on the locking clip and attach the ring shield. A full BA check and adjustment are carried out on the Dzaeger Checkup breathing apparatus test set. Before checking, please ensure that there are no any oxygen leakages in the cylinder valve, at the cylinder and the oxygen distribution unit connection, in the bypass valve, in the shutoff valve of the capillary tube, the pressure gauge, and the external connections of the unit and the signal devices. In order to do it, open the cylinder valve using the soap bubble test. Eliminate the discovered leakages by tightening the nuts or replacing the compacting gaskets. When adjusting the VA parameters, it's preferable to set the average values of each parameter and the tightness parameter close to zero. A detailed description of the breathing apparatus check method is provided in the user manual for the respective control device. If there is no doubt about the proper functioning of the breathing apparatus, consider it suitable for use. You can now review the list of TM Dezega products on the website dezega.com. For detailed information, please feel free to write to us at info@dezega.com.